to our next speaker. And I'd like to introduce her because I think she's done fantastic work and I think you guys will really appreciate what she has to say and the work that she's done. She is an Indian artist who specializes in sculptures, art installations, and paintings. She's also the founder of the Rouble Nagi Art Foundation, which is an NGO that aims to transform the community through art and also conducts workshops for kids throughout India, among other things. She has over 800 murals to her credit and has held many exhibitions worldwide. And what I thought was really, really cool and very significant was her initiative called Misal Mumbai, which is the first slum painting initiative in India, through which, and she corrected my stat because I already thought it was a lot. I said 24,000 houses, but she's painted over 48,000 houses in slums all over. And obviously this project aims to paint houses and that also promotes cleanliness, sanitation, and hygiene. She'll explain how.
Hello everyone. So good to be here. And the minute I entered, I saw so many of you, I was already thrilled because what makes me, in fact, go to any place is people. I always believe that one must connect to people, then to commodities. And Misal Mumbai was all about that. You know, I've been working in the slum for many years now, over a decade of 10 years now. You know, going there and just meeting people was not all that I wanted to do. But initially, when we started our balwaris and pachalas in the slums, parents were not ready to send their children to school. They were like, madam, hum mobile ki dukaan mein kaam kara denge, ek parlor mein ladki ko laga denge. So, you know, they'll start getting some money, income home. And I begged them and I told them, give me just 10 years of your child's life and I will make sure he never has to, you know, look for jobs and disrespect anyone or, you know, just disrespect his parents or her parents too. They would help you for the rest of your life and more than helping you, they would be independent, they would be standing on their own feet. So, you know, it kind of took me 2-3 years to do counseling for parents because unfortunately, sending their children to school wasn't a very happy thing as they wanted that child from the age of 5, 6, 7 or maybe lesser at time should start getting money into the house. So it wasn't easy, like, you know, nothing in life comes easy. You have to work really, really hard. And when those parents, I'm talking about 10 years back when we started this, come back to me today and say, thank you. You know, I feel that now you go and inspire many more parents because there's so many more in our country who still need to go to school. I will only talk about Mumbai first because we are here in Mumbai right now. Mumbai being the most modern, cosmopolitan city of our country, we wouldn't think that there are many children who still don't go to school. So when I started Misal Mumbai in January this year, we started painting Dharavi 2.5 years back, where we are painting the entire Dharavi. When you land into Mumbai, you see everybody cribs about, oh, we see the dirty slums. Now you will see the largest canvas of 550 acres painted on all the roofs of Dharavi homes. So that will complete in about 3 to 4 years. But in between, when two of my students shifted from Chembur, one of the slums in Chembur, to Jafar Baba, which you saw on the video right now, is when I put my eyes on that area for the first time in December. And not that I didn't know about that area, because every time you pay toll on ceiling, you look on your left, you can see the hill. So I went there to teach my children, and when I saw the area, I was like, okay, these guys are going to live here. I don't expect that the slum would become like a 5-star hotel, but because there are people living there, there should be some sense of cleanliness, some sense of hygiene and sanitation. Toilets should be built. You should have schools around their area so that children can study. And that's where I picked up, because being an artist, I start everything, social work, anything in my life which revolves around my work starts with my art, starts with creativity. So I took a team of 40 of my volunteers, walked into Jafar Baba and said, okay, guys, we are going to start with painting, and there will be a lot of people. Shayad to koi log marne ke liye bhi aayenge ki aap kya kar rahe ho. If somebody enters your house and says, you want to paint your wall blue, some will like it, some will not. So that's when we all got in. Then slowly and gradually, the first day we kind of didn't, you know, become brave and just started painting. We spoke to some people there. There are a lot of people who came with a positive input when she told them that we are not going to color, because honestly, I told them that I don't believe in coloring the walls. My whole point is that you live here, and I believe everyone in this world has a right to have a beautiful home. So we are going to waterproof your walls, we are going to waterproof your roofs, because Mumbai has huge rains, and I have seen my children who live in the slums. I have almost 140 slums in villages with me all over India, and I've seen kids sleeping in water till here. They literally have a wooden plank on two sides, and they sit on that, TV is right next to them, watching TV, and they kind of sleep on that. So I said, ye saal, I will try ki maximum gharon mein pani nahi bhara jaye, aur aap log at least on the floor that you're sleeping is not wet. So they kind of, you know, started understanding that why she's here. Like there was a gentleman who came and said, Pandit ji, he said, madam, aap hamara land hathiyane aayo. So I, you know, looked at him, I smiled at him, I said, you know what, uncle, you really think in this 38 degrees, standing here, this is government land, not even your own land. I can come from somewhere and hathiyaro your land. You really think I really need to do it? You don't think looking at me that I live a good luxury life? Why do you think I need to be here? I'm here for you because I want your children to go to school. I want your grandchildren to go to school. So I want to see you guys happy. That's why I'm here. So third day onwards, I had my whole team of 150 volunteers from that area itself. So I never had to carry my dabba. I never had to carry anything after the fourth day. I got tea every day. I got samosas, vada pav, lunch. It was like a red carpet for me. And then we started getting a lot of people from the community to come and paint with us, clean the garbage. Because when they see you cleaning, I tell them, I'm going to not live here forever. You're going to live here. I'm here to clean for 1 month, 1.5 months, till my project lasts. After that, I want you people to take responsibility and take it forward and keep your area clean. The amount of money you're spending on children health in the hospital, if you keep your areas clean, you will save that much money. So you know, it takes time for them to understand, because nobody, I realize why, because nobody has really gone and spoken to them. People barely even go there and spend time with them. They just go take photographs and, oh, we visited a slum, we visited a garib area, and you know, it's all over social media, but what actually is happening there? So, and I never believed in a term called charity. I always believe in equality. What is charity? And we are nobody to do charity for anyone. If you want to help someone, let's not think. Let's not, like a lot of people say that we, you know, you talk about doing something that you love so much, follow your passion, blah, blah, blah. How do you find time? I said, well, in nothing in life you want to do, you will find time. You have to manage time. There is nothing called time management. There is something called self-management. You have to manage your own self. I'm a wife, I'm a mother, I'm a daughter, I run an NGO, I do my art, I'll sleep a little less, and probably, you know, concentrate on doing more things that you really love so much. So it's all about what you decide to do. My team started from a very small number. Today we are almost 1 million+ people all over India who are connected to Masal Mumbai. We started with Mumbai because I live here, but today we go pan India. We are working in 8 different states. How have those people come forward? By word of mouth, by seeing what we are doing, connect, one person emails, ma'am, I have this village, we want to do this. So this is how transformation happens. And most of my team is students like you. Some of them are educated, some of them are not. In Thane itself, if, I don't know if any of you have gone to Thane, we've transformed 3 slums there. In one slum, we've taken 2,500 children to school. Now can you believe, in a city like Mumbai, Thane, which is like so modern, there are still so many children in these areas who don't go to school. So what are we talking about? What are we talking about growth, and what are we talking about development? Because I very strongly believe, I don't know if I will live long enough to see my country 100% literate, because that's my dream. I want to see every child of my country, every youngster, every woman educated. I'm not talking about holding business degrees. I'm talking about basic education, starting from primary education to secondary and then going to college. Because no matter what you give them, it's not going to stay with them forever. But their degree is something, is like a blessing you can give in their hand, which will at even 70 not make them beg, borrow, but still get some job where they can at least, you know, live a comfortable, decent life. They don't have to ask, go and ask others. So that is very important, you know, and I always tell all my students, all my volunteers, that it's you create your own legacy. It's not about the amount of money you have in your bank, which is also important, but it is how many people's life you have touched while you're working, while you are with them, is what is your true legacy. So do not work to earn money. Work to earn respect. Because I very strongly believe money can be earned. You just need to be hardworking, and if it is meant to be, things will fall in place. But with that, you must also follow your inner heart. You must also follow your passion, because if you get to do, I'm lucky and I'm thankful that I get to do what I love the most, my art and my social work. I love people and I want to see them happy. When they give me a cup of tea and old Mossy comes and puts her hand on my head and says, I'm so happy you're here, nobody comes for us, and she gives a sad story to you and you just listen at that time, you know, it just makes her happy. She says, there was a lady when we were doing Welingkars village, and she's a maid, she goes to many different homes for cleaning, and she walks up to me and she says, from last half an hour you were standing with us and at least listening to us is making my heart so light. So I said, but why would you not? You have so many friends in the village. Why do you not talk? I said, madam, nobody has time. So at time you realize, you know, in a busy life that we live, you giving your time to somebody also can change that person's life. It's not about only giving money. So, you know, at time, the time that you spend, that's why I call it quality time. Because time stops for nobody. Today we are here, tomorrow we are somewhere else. Today you guys are studying here, tomorrow you guys will be at some job, or maybe, you know, wherever you guys are there, if I come to speak, I will, we'll probably see each other again. So it's all about managing your time right. It's about connecting to people. Connect to people, that is very important. And connect to people with an open heart. Because it is so wonderful that, you know, it's somebody that you connect to, you meet, you speak, you land up learning so much from them, which you have not even in your wildest dream thought that, oh my God, this is the security guy going to say something like that, which might just work so fabulously. So, you know, it's all about connecting people. For me, Misal Mumbai, it's an initiative for people. We are not just coloring the slums. We make sure we build toilets for them, because, you know, I have seen pregnant ladies walking to another areas, which is good 15, 20 minutes of walk to go use a washroom. Not just pregnant ladies, even it's tough for regular people, old people, children. So, you know, we want to reach out to as many as possible. In Rishikesh, we've just transformed 42 schools with Pooja Swamiji, who's such a wonderful person, and we thought of this together. And with one school that we only painted and repaired, there were 150 children who were going to that school, suddenly nobody comes. And there's not more than 20, 25 children. Today, all those 150 plus kids have come back to school. Because would you like to study sitting under a roof which might just fall any time on your head, and you might just get very badly injured or probably at times die, or it's the walls are leaking? No. So I told them, you know what, you don't have to spend too much money. Just do a little bit of transformation in the happy art in your schools, and you will see how many kids will come back. So with one sample kind of school, today we've done 42 schools. So it's always about how you want. Now if somebody is giving you a long, boring lecture, maybe mine too, but still it won't be that fascinating. But if somebody connects with you one-on-one, somebody talks to you, you know, we all have problems. And you always want that one friend or that one person whom you can share a lot. Now that is what Misal Mumbai, me and my team, is doing to everybody who lives in the rural India. In Bombay we call it slums, in Delhi we call them bastis and areas, or dusre gaon mein unko gaon bolte hain, village bolte hain. So you know, you connect with people, that's very important. And I would say it's always teamwork. I always applaud my team, because without them, Rouble Nagi cannot stand in 140 areas and, you know, take the jhadu and clean, take the paint brushes, take the kadiye ka kaam, I can't do it. So it's the people, the community which lives there, when they come and join hands with us and my team and volunteers. I've had students from most of the colleges in Maharashtra they've come and participated with us. They come tomorrow. I'm doing a very big cleanliness drive at Bharat Nagar in BKC. We have almost 1,000 plus people coming. And so far, I have not even put it up on any of the social media handle that we're doing it. It's a community which is so enthusiastic and so participating that we want to come and do it. So it is about bringing that change. I'm not going to live in that area. These people are going to live. So it's very important that they learn that they have to keep their area clean. Swachhata pe hum sabka adhikar hai. It is very important. A lot of people tell me these slums are going to break, why are you wasting your time? So I tell them, I've been in Bombay for 20 years and I haven't seen anything breaking. These people, even if they live there for 1 year, 6 months, 5 years, 2 years, I'm going to transform where they live because I refuse to see them living like that because they're not animals, they're humans. My driver, half of my staff comes from those areas. So how can people talk like that, that you know these are going to break, you're giving them a permanent home? I said they deserve a permanent home. You give them, you're going to relocate them, give them something they want to stay in. You cannot just tell them get out and we are going to build something here. It doesn't work like that. So they understand that, okay, why this is happening, and this is what even the people in slums, they like about you and they respect you, that you know somebody is standing and voicing on our behalf. Because we've been voicing from so long, madam, hame to pani nahi hai, toilets nahi hai. And you know, when I tell them, why are you sitting in, like, in public, why this? They come back to me and they say, where do we go? You give us a place and we will not go in open, ma'am. We are shy going, ladies come and we feel extremely shy going in, you know, sitting outside in public. So that's when I tell my friends who are head of those areas that, no, answer this. When they say, I tell them, why you do it openly? They tell me, where do we do it? What do we do? So give them a solution. So that's where we kind of got into building toilets, cleaning toilets which were already there. There were a lot of them which were four walls but half made, got them completed. There are a lot of women in the slums who want to sit at home and work with their children. So we started skill development classes for them. We train them to work from home so that they can get their livelihood, and you know, it's not just the money that they will earn, they are like, you know, we have this huge sense of respect in front of my in-laws and my husband. Youngsters, I see youngsters, hugely alcohol addicts in all slums, drug addicts. So we are kind of, you know, trying to change their mind and say that don't ruin yourself. I know drinking is, I'm not against drinking, but I'm not in favor of you getting addicted to it. So we have sent a few youngsters, wonderful boys, to rehab, which breaks my heart, but we have done it. And we do a lot of career counseling for youngsters. Some of them have done their degrees, but they don't know what to do after, or where should they apply for jobs. So, you know, we kind of guide them, we give them a platform, wherever, whichever friend of ours is running a big corporate or industry, we kind of try to place them there. We do all these things, we do medical camps. So, in total, we bring together a team where we kind of want to solve as many problems as possible. And I would be very happy if you guys ever want to volunteer, because we work 7 days a week only. So we kind of don't take it off. So in case you guys want to, because I know you guys have a lot of studies, a lot of pressure, but there's no fun in life if you don't have pressure. Like if my life was just a smooth sailing boat, I would be so bored. So my husband actually sometimes comes back to me and says, you call for trouble. And I'm like, yeah, kind of sometimes, but that's fine. If you don't have challenges, if you don't have a target, if you're not motivated enough to live life to fullest, it's going to be waste. Because we get only one life, and I think we must do full justice to it. And what better life than if you choose the life of service? It's the best thing, trust me. The feeling, the true hug, and the affection you get from people, which you know is 100,000% genuine, is amazing. So I would request all of you that if you ever want to help or support anyone, don't think. Just do it. Whether it fits in at that time or it doesn't, later on, you will realize it will fit in. Because you're not doing it for yourself, you're doing it for somebody who really needs it. So let's all get together
and help and support as many as we can, because there are so many more, in true sense, so many more in millions who need it. And I hope we can all together do it, because I say, hashtag together we can. It's always a teamwork, not just my effort alone. So the applause is for everyone, including all of you. Thank you so much.
That is lit. Woo!